Hi, hello friends, welcome to SPV Education World. Together we create a better world. If you are not yet subscribed to our channel, kindly subscribe to our channel. Also, you can contribute to our channel for the development of this channel and to help many poor students, as many as we can. My dear friend, this is me, SP Rajan alias SPR, taking classes for you in Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English, a first ever education channel where we teach for all competitive exams from VU to IAS. All exams just for free, my dear friends. This is my initiative through SPV Education World. You can also be part of this education world by through your donations or by spreading the word that I can, because I cannot reach over to the every place and these things, my dear friend. Also, this is not an entertainment video, there it can be easily promoted in YouTube, but thing is that you students must take as an initiative and spread it to the as many friends and students who are in needy, because and rural students still as students are struggling hard to get themselves placed in good government jobs. And also I'm also the one among the rural students, my dear friends. I struggled a lot to learn myself all the classes, these things, and also be part of this my initiative, my dear friends. Okay, thank you all those who had subscribed and also keep supporting to our channel. We'll make more initiative and more interesting things, my dear friends. Now we're gonna come to the geography session of part 2. In this geography today we will be seeing what are all the details in geography in detail of other topics one by one, my dear friends. The topic that we're gonna deal today is a structure of the earth or interior of the earth. By seeing the image itself, you know that interior of the earth is not homogeneous, which means the earth inside us, which means we are living on the earth. If you go dig deep inside the earth, there are many evidences that it is not just a single layer, it is a formation of multiple layer. One more thing we must know, my dear friend, because did we dig deep into the earth? No, my dear friend, as deep as maximum distance is around 8 to 20 kilometers or 10 kilometers, I think so. Maximum depth it was digged, my dear friend, but still how we had brought the evidences. It is by the evidence of seismic waves. Seismic wave means earthquake waves or earth waves. With these waves, we had found out that earth is not homogeneous. It had subdivided into layers. In this class, we will be seeing the interior of the earth in detail. And next class, let me explain what is this seismic waves. What are the types of seismic waves? You will be getting a clear idea of all the seismic waves and seismic activity, my dear friends. Now we shall go too deep into the earth's interior, my dear friends. As we know, the earth interior is divided into different layers, such as the topmost is called as crust, and the next to it is mantle, and then interior or deep inside a circular part is called as core. Now we shall see in detail or different points of the earth, my dear friend. Here we shall see in this class shape of the earth and layers that are present in the earth, which means a crust, a mantle and core. And next, all these parts has its own discontinuity. Those discontinuities also will be dealing in clear, and then we shall remember what are the important points that are needed for this topic, my dear friend. Now we shall see here, this is the image you must be clearly remembering, how the earth is divided, how it is multiply sectioned. See here, the topmost layer is called, it is 0 to 100 kilometers, it is called as crust, which means it is also crust plus upper mantle. Mostly it is solid, those both is combinedly called as a lithosphere. Below the lithosphere there is a soft and molten lava flowing, it is called as asthenosphere. And then below it comes a mantle. Mantle is divided into two parts, upper mantle and a lower mantle. And next we come to the core. If you come to the core, it is around 2900 kilometers and depth inside. It is around how much? It is a outer core and inner core. Outer core is mostly liquid, but inner core is solid. How it is? See here, my dear friends, as you go inside, the temperature is continuously increasing. Even the temperature is continuously increasing, but why the inner core is solid and outer core is liquid is question most of the time you will get in exams. If you are writing a UPSC exam, it will be sure shot a most expected questions, my dear friend. Here it is because high pressure, the melting point of the inner core will be higher. See, when you apply more pressure, the melting point also will be increased, so that obviously even in a high temperature, the inner part, which means the inner core, will be solid. All the evidences we can see in through seismic waves, my dear friend. Now we shall see what is the shape of the earth. As we know that earth is not a perfect circular shape, it is in the shape of an apple. Do you know the shape of the apple, my dear friend? Most of you know, because most of you are eager to buy this Apple phone which had its bite. See here, friend, apple, which means the most a top and south, which means a north pole and south pole, it will be little flat. It is a shape of oblate shape or geoid shape, we used to call it as geoid shape is the shape of the earth and it is slightly flattened at the poles, which means a top, which means a north pole and south pole, it will be flattened or bulging in the equator. So equator will be little bulgy. This is the original shape of the earth, my dear friend. Now we shall see in detail of the four different parts of the layers of the earth. And first part, which means topmost layer, is called as crust. Let me explain it in the image, then we go into the theoretical part, my dear friend. Here earth, if you see this, the earth has two things, a continental crust and ocean crust. Always continental crust floats on the ocean crust because ocean crust has much denser than thicker or density more than a continental crust. So it is beneath the continental crust. You can observe this yellow layer is beneath, which means below the continental crust. Between the continental crust and ocean crust, there lies a sedimentary deposit. Why the sedimentary deposit? Because the particles in the continental crust are slowly moves on to the ocean crust or ocean floor, because the ocean crust will be little below. Below that, there lies a lithosphere layer. So and also after we can see that a plastic asthenosphere is below the lithosphere. You can find this, my dear friend. Asthenosphere is below the lithosphere and the upper mantle. Between both there is a layer, which means lava. Now we can see this volcano eruption, everything that doesn't come from the core of the earth. You may think that from the core or center of the earth the lava is blasting over to the top of the earth. No, that's not the thing, my dear friend. There is a layer which is called as asthenosphere, my dear friend. That layer mostly pumps out the volcanoes. Now we shall see here, what is crust? It is the outermost layer of the earth. It has two types, a continental crust and ocean crust, as I had explained in the image. And next, composition. If you come to the composition, mostly continental crust has made of solid particles or solid rocks, and mostly it is made of lighter elements like silicon, aluminium, oxygen. These are all lighter elements. See here, silicon and aluminium. So we call it as Cl, Si and Al, silicon, aluminium. So it called as Cl, or other name it is felsic. See here, if you ask a felsic or Cl, both are indicating the crust, my dear friend. And next, if you come to the composition, the elements and percentages of the elements present in the crust. See here, the percentage, if you calculate here, oxygen has the highest percentage in the earth crust. If they ask if what is the highest amount, highest material present, elements present in the earth crust, it is oxygen, my dear friend. It is 47%, and silicon is 28%, and aluminium it is 8%, and iron is 5%, calcium is 3.5%. You must know the order if you are preparing for UPSC, because in UPSC they doesn't give ask oxygen which is the topmost or which is the lowest. They just give a sequence, which means a row. So they will be giving in line, arrange it in ascending order or descending order. So you must know the row or flow: oxygen, silicon, aluminium, and iron and calcium. And if you see which are all highly in a compound format, if you check it over in a compound format, silica is highly present in compound format. Silica means not silicon, my dear friend. Silicon means pure Si, but silica means it is SiO2, which is a compound. So which is a compound and present in higher percentage, if you compare it, it is silica is in a higher percentage. Then comes the aluminium, then comes the lime. These are all the things that we must be learning about crust, my dear friend. Now if we come to the next part of the earth layer, it is mantle. You can see this image, my dear friend. A mantle is below the lithosphere. Here mostly convectional current flows due to the asthenosphere, and asthenosphere also keeps on rotating, and this is also one of the reason where the ridges and the many divisions between the earth. So you see here slab pull or ridges formed, and lithosphere activities, trenches are formed. Both these are evidence are provided by the mantle's convectional flow of lava or these things, my dear friend. See here, we shall see a mantle in detail. The layer below the crust is called as a mantle. What are all the composition of it? It is made of, what is the mantle is made of? It is made of silicon, oxygen and magnesium. See here, before previously we found that aluminium is present, but in mantle you can see that magnesium is high percentage. So we call this as sima. Silicon and magnesium is present in mantle, so we call it as sima. And other name of it is called as mafic. Mafic is also indicates that mantle, and also density of the mantle increases gradually with depth. This is a statement mostly you can get, my dear friend. If you are going deep into the mantle, the depth, the density of it continuously keeps on increasing. And also if you see the layer subdivisions of the mantle, the upper mantle is mostly a solid base of crust, which means below the crust, it is a highly solid and made of heavy rock peridotite. This is the rock material made of, and also upper asthenosphere, below the upper mantle there lies a upper asthenosphere. The layer is fluidic due to its high pressure and temperature. See here why the asthenosphere is a liquidic or fluidic, it is because of high pressure and high temperature, and it is the movement, it is the main thing which is the reason the movement of continental plates are happening, my dear friends. And then we can see lower asthenosphere, then lies the lower mantle. Now we can find clearly the crust plus upper mantle is called as lithosphere. See here, what is lithosphere? It is crust plus a mantle, upper mantle, not only complete mantle, it is upper mantle, my dear friend. And below the lithosphere there lies a asthenosphere, and below that there lies a lower mantle. Now we can get a clarity, and there is no any problematics in learning, my dear friend. This is what we must know about a mantle in detail. And next, if you come to the core, this is the center of the earth, which means the main core of the earth. If you take the earth as skin, if you divide, you can see this image, my dear friend. You are skinning out the earth. See here, topmost layer is a crust, and then you get the mantle, and then you get this outer core, and center is called as inner core. Now we shall see here, my dear friend, innermost layer of the earth. See here, innermost layer of the earth is called as a core. And what are all the composition that are present in the core? You can see here, mostly solid iron and nickel. See here, iron means Fe, nickel means Ni. These are all highly present in the core of the earth. So if you find this iron and nickel in the center or core of the earth, so we call this as, it is also with the other name called as Niphe, which means Niphe means it is core of the earth, and because of the materials present in the core, we call it as Niphe. Then we shall see the layers of the earth, outer layer and inner layer. If you consider the outer layer, which means I had already explained to you bit about that outer layer, it is mostly molten layer of the mantle. Below the mantle it will be molten. See here, this one, this is the outer core, it is in stage of molten form. And also the inner core is solid, always the inner core is solid because high pressure, I already said to you, my dear friend, because of high pressure and high temperature the melting point increases, so the inner core lies in a solid form. This may be many times it has been asked, and it also in future it will be also be clarity of learning those things. If I miss any topics, kindly mention in the comment section, my dear friend. I will be adding that to the next class. Okay, now most important thing that you must be remembering, and bit hard for many students to remember, what discontinuities, which means when they had passed seismic waves. I would have taken seismic waves first, but you can learn in next class what are all these seismic waves, my dear friend. Seismic waves, my dear friend. Before learning these seismic waves, whenever the seismic wave pass into the earth's interior, it will be slightly converted, which means it will be diverted. So each time diverting, there will be a discontinuity, which means there is a change in the layer. So if there is a change in the layer, which means there is a discontinuity present in these layers. So those are the discontinuities we'll be seeing in detail, my dear friends. And also why these boundaries between the earth layers. Okay, what is discontinuities? These are all the boundaries between the earth layers. How do you found that? It is based on the seismic waves. Just as seismic waves had given the evidences for you to see this discontinuous, my dear friend. Now we shall see one by one. Kindly, my dear friend, whenever I say theory, you watch it. And the image also, you must be alternatively watching, so that you will be having a clarity in learning. Now we shall see here, Conard discontinuity. What is Conard discontinuity? The Conard discontinuity is upper crust and lower crust. Here, they had divided crust into two parts, which means upper crust and lower crust. Between them, there lies a Conard discontinuity. See here, the image, first thing, it is a lithosphere first, my dear friend. Below the lithosphere, here lies the asthenosphere, and then lies the mesosphere. See here, what are the, wherever the mantle present, upper mantle and lower mantle, it is called as mesosphere. And then the inner core and outer core combined, we call as barysphere. Now, the Conard discontinuity is present between upper crust and lower crust. And first, it was named by whom? Victor Conard is the person who named this Conard discontinuity. Next, we can see this Mohr discontinuity. What is it? Mohr discontinuity, which means Mohorovicic discontinuity. It is between the crust and asthenosphere. See here, my dear friend, asthenosphere is a fluid like substance that is flowing below the earth, and between the crust and asthenosphere there lies a discontinuity is called as Mohr discontinuity. It is named after Adrija Mohr. Okay, it's not a matter because the founder, they won't ask most of the time. It lies deep depth of about 20 miles in continents and also 4 to 6 miles in the oceans. It is given in miles, my dear friend. If you convert into kilometers, it will be around 30 kilometers approximately. In that depth it will be lying, my dear friends. Next we shall see here repetitive discontinuity is between upper mantle and lower mantle. See here, my dear friends, here there is two things, upper mantle and lower mantle sima. In between that there is a discontinuity, it is called as repetitive discontinuity. Then Gutenberg discontinuity, if you come to that, Gutenberg discontinuity is it is between lower mantle and outer core. See here, here it is a core and here is a lower mantle. Between that there lies a continuity discontinuity. It is called as a Gutenberg discontinuity. And next there comes a Lehmann discontinuity. Lehmann discontinuity is between outer core and inner core. See here, the division in a barysphere. See here, if they ask barysphere, it is a core. Mesosphere, it is mantle. Okay, you don't confuse with these things, my dear friend. And here we shall see outer core and inner core. Between them there lies a Lehmann discontinuity. These are all the important things that you must be learning, my dear friend. Now we shall see few important points that you must be remembering, my dear friend. Lithosphere means it is crust plus upper mantle, both you combine call it as lithosphere, and it has a oceanic lithosphere and also we call it as a continental lithosphere wherever it is situated, my dear friends. And also one more thing, the thickness of the continental crust is higher in ocean crust. You can see here, always a continental crust is thicker than ocean crust, but if you come to density, ocean crust is much denser than continental crust. You must be dividing this clearly, my dear friend. Thickness, continental crust is higher, but density, oceanic crust is higher. And if you come to the mantle, and here mantle is the largest layer. This is the confusion you will be getting, my dear friend. Most of the time they will be asking the highest or large or like high by mass, largest layer or by mass or volume, it is mantle, my dear friend. And also it is followed by crust and core. See, first position, if you ask in a descending order, the first position goes to mantle, second crust, and then third is a core. These are all the things, my dear friend. And earth's density increases gradually, crust to core. See, the density is always increasing from the top to bottom or center. It is to the core. And oceanic crust is much denser than the continental crust. I had said already, thickness, continents is larger, but if you compare with oceanic crust at density, the oceanic crust is much denser, my dear friend. You know those reasons and this thing, because oceanic crust is mostly formed by a lava, molten lava, my dear friend. But the land is continental crust is not always made of all that lava. These are all the things we must be learning in this session, my dear friends. We shall see other things in next class. So this is SPV Education World, together create a better world. So subscribe. If you're not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe, and also you can donate to our channel for the further development. This is first of our channel teaching in Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English. So just bet not get confused. Kindly subscribe and support. This is me, SP Rajan, signing off alias SPR. Kindly watch our playlist so that you'll be understanding whatever the topics that I had created, a playlist that are important for your education or exam purposes. And future I'll be creating a more interesting things with your support, my dear friends. Thank you. Signing off. Bye. Take care.